shall be put to death, whether small or great, whether man or woman.
All right, so it says whether small, great, man or woman, man, if you don't seek the Most High God of Israel, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob in these last days, and you're going to be put to death, man. That's going to be your end result, is to have a punishment of death. You know what I'm saying? So read that. Keep reading on that, actually. 2 Chronicles chapter 15. We're going to get the next verse. Right? So everybody in these last days should be seeking the Most High God.
Right.
The God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob.
Right.
Who do you guys seek? Do you guys seek Buddha? Who do you guys seek, man? What is it, the year of the dragon right now? Is it the year of the sheep?
Year of the dragon, yep.
Bring it up.
2 Chronicles 15 and 14. And they swear unto the Most High with a loud voice, and with shouting, and with trumpets, and with coronets. And all Judah rejoiced at the oath.
He said, and all what?
And all Judah rejoiced at the oath.
Right, and all Judah rejoiced at the oath, man. What was that oath? Hey, that we're going to serve Yahweh, man.
That's right.
We're going to serve the Most High God in these last days,
that's
man.
Right.
And who is Judah? Judah is so-called African Americans. Hey, how y'all doing, family? Y'all got a minute for the word? Come hear the word of God real quick. Scripture of the day. One scripture.
Hey,
I put the mic down. Scripture of the day. Scripture of the day. Come on, family man. Yeah, that is Kush. Y'all East African?
That's why they hit the guy.
Okay, yeah. Kush. Kush. Yeah. They said they not like us, huh? Yeah, no, they not. But keep going on that.
For they had sworn with all their heart and sought him with their whole desire. And he was found of them.
He was what?
And he was found of them. Uh-huh. And the Lord gave them rest round about.
Right. So if you seek the Most High God, man, the Most High is going to give you rest round about, man. You know what I'm saying? So again, we are out here for so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native American Indians. We're out here to restore unto you your heritage, what was taken from you in slavery, man. Can you turn this around for me right quick, King? You know what I'm saying? These are the atrocious things that Europeans have done to so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, of which they have not been paid back for. And the Lord is going to bring about this great payback, man. He's going to bring about this great payback for the Native Americans, man, for the indigenous peoples. He's going to bring about this great payback, you know what I'm saying, for so-called black people, for the Haitian people, for the Jamaican people. God is going to bring a big payback, in the words of James Brown, man. You know what I'm saying? The big payback is going to come to the earth, man, and it's coming real soon. And how is it going to come? By thermonuclear destruction.
That's right.
America's going to be destroyed by the likes of Russia, China, North Korea, you know what I'm saying? And all of their allies, man. Iran, all of it, and even America's allies is going to turn on them real soon. That's going to come to pass, man. This is future prophecies getting ready to take place. How you doing, King?
If that happens, where are you going to move to?
Well, I'm not moving nowhere. I'm going to tell you what's going to happen, right? Give me Revelation chapter 18 and 4. You know what I'm saying? Give me Revelation 18 and 4. And then also get me Isaiah chapter 11. Isaiah chapter 11 and get me verse 13. All right, bring this out, King.
This is Revelations 18 and 4. And I heard another voice from heaven saying, come out of her, my people.
What did they say?
Come out of her, my people, that ye be not partakers of her sins, and that ye receive not of her plague.
Right, so he's telling, the Most High is telling his people, come out of her. Who is the her? It's referring to that great city Babylon. Right, so now, but is he saying to physically pack up and leave? No, because we know through the prophecies of like the likes of the prophet Jeremiah, he said that sword could follow you wherever you at. You know what I'm saying? The Most High could bring his judgment upon you wherever you at. So you want to make sure wherever you are located that you are spiritually in tune with the Most High God.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And that way you will be protected. Matter of fact, drop that. Give me Psalms 91 and verse 5. Bring this up, okay?
For her sins have reached unto heaven, and God have remembered her iniquity.
Right. Once America has reached a certain pinnacle of iniquity in the earth, that's when God is going to bring about his judgment. He's going to send his son, he's going to send all of the millions of holy angels to deliver his people as that judgment is precisely going on.
This question. You really think that he's still waiting? I mean, when they came to kill Indians, they literally
almost a genocide, to say the least, right?
Right.
And here we are in 2024, right, doing a lot better. So you think he's still waiting for something worse?
So,
and if so, what would that be? What's the worst? What's worse than killing an entire land of individuals?
Okay, so who is the he that would be waiting? Are you,
well, whoever came over. Us.
Us.
You're saying, when America reaches its level of iniquity, right? So I'm saying, after the worst that happened initially, you think he's still waiting for something? What's worse than wiping the land out of the locals?
Right. So you said, but what's worse
because
than us
now,
waiting?
From wiping the land out of its initial locals to building up,
right,
and trying to help the neighboring countries like America's done, you're saying God is still waiting.
So, but you said America has helped the neighboring countries.
It has helped a lot of neighboring countries.
Okay, but okay. So, but now when we look at today's time, how have we, the people on this side?
No one is perfect.
But hold on. But how have the people on this side benefited from what America has done?
Well, no one is perfect. A lot of people have benefited.
Have we benefited financially?
Well, a lot of people have. I mean,
but what people?
I mean, look at you. You're looking nice. You're wearing
dresses. Brother, that don't mean nothing. This means absolutely nothing.
No, but right. I'm saying some people are happy. Some people are not.
Yes.
You might say most are not. But there are a lot of happy people. And this comes from Atlanta started with zero.
Okay.
As in wiping out the initial local population.
Mm-hmm.
And to today, actually from that to slavery to... better, you know, to the release of slaves, the Martin Luther's, till today, the LeBrons, the, you know, all the celebrities, the Michael Jacksons and whatnot.
Right.
So you really think God is still waiting for something worse to
happen?
Well,
this is the thing, brother, because, look, because you have, we have a very small percentage of our people that are either athletes or entertainers.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? The majority of billionaires on the earth are European.
Don't take that that's an isolated event, of course, talking about the athletes. But there are a lot of people, there are a lot of blacks in school.
We do thrive in certain areas, but this is what you have to understand, brother.
Uh-huh.
We are God's chosen people. We are going to thrive even in the most harsh conditions.
Right.
Now, you flip positions. You flip roles. Would white people survive all of this stuff that if we did that to them?
Bring that out.
Will they survive?
Would they survive if we did the same exact things to them? Would they have survived? But let me get the scripture right quick. We stand on the Bible, right? Go ahead.
Habakkuk chapter 2. And verse 12,
uh-huh.
Woe to him that builds a town with blood.
What does the Bible say?
Woe to him that builds a town with blood.
Right. America was built off the bloodshed, sweat, and tears of blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, right? And God says, let's finish the scripture real quick.
Right.
He says, woe means death,
of
destruction
course,
unto this people.
Yeah.
Right, go ahead.
And establish a city by iniquity.
Right. Because with the same manner and approach that they took to overtake this land, they also implemented laws that people cannot do those same very things that they did. That's an evil and wicked thing. Brother, would you not agree that they are hypocrites in doing so?
It's hard to of course.
Okay.
But graded on the curve, right? Look around the world.
Mm-hmm.
Who is doing it a lot better?
Who is doing it a lot better?
Because Russia, they would complain something of the nature. Go to Africa, they would say something. Go to Asia. I mean, for Christ's sake, look around the world.
Yeah.
Why do you think a lot of their people, despite what's going on here, will still come here for a better chance at helping those back home?
Right. Give me Isaiah 66 and verse 4. I got you right here. I got you. So now check this out. I still want that one, right? So now check this out. Because America gives a facade. Like everything
everybody
is peachy.
Lies. No one is perfect.
Well, hold on. But see, you keep going back to everybody is this, everybody is that, nobody's perfect.
We're all sinners.
But this is the thing, right?
Okay.
America gives a facade like everything is nice. For instance, you have Nicki Minaj, right? Before she came over here to the States, she said, I thought, you know, it was just a place of gold. You know what I'm saying? Money grew on trees over here. And she got here and she lived in the worst ghettos of, I believe, was it the Bronx or something?
Pause,
like that.
Pause right
Queens.
There before you move forward.
Huh?
Before you move forward. Do you know that in certain countries, a person can literally come to your house, your neighbor can come to your house with the belief that he's superior and just take your things. And if you call the police.
Well, that sounds like
America. They don't do that here. They use a warrant.
Yeah,
they use a warrant.
Let me know.
Let me
know. Hold on, brother.
Check
this out. Hold on. Because I like what you just said.
Have you ever lived in another country? Because it's worse somewhere else.
No, I personally haven't. Okay, I can agree with that. But even check this out. I want to hit you with something. Because last year I read an article about the countries in which, in the places that they rank all throughout the world. America didn't even make the top 10.
Who was number one?
Well, I can't call who was number one, but I do remember. I mean, you could go to like some European countries. You could go to places within Africa, and you could find some countries that are actually thriving. Unbeknownst to America, because look, who controls the Western media?
Bring that out. Man.
Who controls that? So they're gonna always give you an illusion to believe, a facade to believe that everything is perfect over here and everywhere else is just a third world country.
Right.
They gonna always do that to you. But give me that right quick, real fast. Isaiah 66, verse 4. Who got
it? This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 66, verse 4. I also will choose their delusion.
What is believing that America is the perfect place?
I also will choose their delusion.
Right, so God gave people strong delusions to believe that America is a perfect place, man. Spotless, blameless, man.
Trust me.
We're gonna finish it.
I'm not saying it's blameless, right? But this book.
Okay. And will bring their fears upon them, because when I called, none did answer. When I spake, they did not hear.
Real quick, what's your name, King?
Ebenezer.
Ebenezer, where are you from?
Cameroon, West Africa.
Cameroon, okay, West Africa, bring it up. You got something to say? About Haiti, right?
I just wanted to mention,
how's Haiti living? Based off of how the Americans are coming over there taking the resources.
The French
as well, but you have Hillary Clinton and Bill Clinton as well.
With
their foundation going to Haiti and taking resources, right? So America's not as great as you might think it is. And part of that belief is because you come from Cameroon.
It's not
a thriving place in Cameroon.
You're discarding my awareness.
Be realistic, brother.
Right.
When did you get
awareness.
Over here? When did you come to America? Long time ago? Okay, so but you are pretty much first generation here in America.
You can say.
Okay, so this is where that idea comes from, that America is perfect.
You're discarding my awareness.
As far as what?
I am aware of a lot of things.
Okay.
Not just where I came from, not just where I'm standing, but other people's plights. Because I see them complaining. If you look online, you hear them complaining. If you met other people, there aren't a lot of countries that you go to. Right? Even this book that you're reading.
Yeah.
Who wrote the book?
Our ancestors.
And like you just, who is our ancestors?
So-called black people's ancestors.
Is this a special Bible? Or is it just the Bible?
Bible.
It's just the Bible, right? Okay, you do know that the Roman Catholic Church is, how could you put it? Which that is from the Roman Catholic Church, right?
Wow.
This is the Bible.
No, it didn't come from them. The Torah is the law.
The Torah is the law, right?
That was written over 3,000 years ago.
But let me put it this way. Human beings wrote the Bible, right?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Did human beings write the mathematics books?
Inspiration.
Did human beings write history books?
Human beings have done a lot of things.
Which
is my point exactly. At some point, it's a coordinated, let's say, effect, right? So, like you said a few minutes ago, we will choose their delusions.
Well, God said he's going to choose man's delusions.
And I like the way you phrase it. You relate the book straight to God, written by a human being under a coordinated effect.
Yes. First Peter chapter.
So my point is that the person you might be speaking against wrote that book. Right?
Say that last part one more time.
Like, for example, Rome. Catholic, Christianity, of course, is worldwide, but who started Christianity?
Who started Christianity?
Yeah. Even the idea of Jesus Christ, the name Jesus Christ.
Right.
The whole philosophy and the lifestyle behind it.
Well, this is the thing, right? We don't teach Christianity.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Christianity is a religion, which was pretty much.
You don't teach Christianity.
Christianity. Right. We do follow Christ, but Christianity is separate from what? Because turn this around right quick. These people right here, turn it around. These people were Christians. They had a certain doctrine that they believed.
Right.
And they also did stuff like this. Castrate black men, burn them on a stake.
Thank you.
You know what I'm saying?
These kind of people put together these kind of books.
No, absolutely not.
Who put that book together?
That's good. We're going to show you right now.
Who put the book together?
Psalm 68 and verse 11. And give me Deuteronomy 9 and 9. Bring this out.
This is 2 Peter chapter 1 and verse 20. Knowing this first, that no prophecy
of the scripture is of any private interpretation.
Meaning,
no part of the scripture is of any private interpretation.
Meaning, somebody can't. Somebody can say, I believe it says this. And another person says, no, I kind of see it this way. And then somebody else comes along and says, both of y'all wrong. Look, this is how I view it. No private interpretation. Go ahead.
For the prophecy came not in old time by the will of man.
So this book wasn't put together by man's will. It wasn't put together by man's will. It was inspired by, go ahead.
But the holy men of God spake as they were moved by the Holy Ghost.
Right. So now
slow
go
down
check
there.
This out.
Slow down. Let's zoom into that.
Holy men, right? Holy men. So what is the word holy men?
I would imagine divine intervention. Okay. But that's from what I am. My awareness.
Okay. Let's see what's my awareness out the Bible.
My awareness still knows that human beings are very smart. The movies you watch that are compelling, it's a human being that put it together.
Yes, but you know where
the
to get the inspiration. Wait.
And do you even know?
Before you go continue, let me tell you this, because I like that you brought out movies. So now, do you know, even going back to when films started being created, you know where they got their inspiration from?
Awesome.
The Bible. Every director, every writer, every screenplay, no matter what it is, they get their inspiration from the Bible. The movie 300, it comes from the Bible, man.
I'm glad you say that. Let me tell you something. A lot of philosophies that we know today were as in existed long ago. Do you know when it comes to Christianity, there have been like 16 other religions just like that? My point is, human beings are very, very smart.
I think what it is, you give the white man too much credit.
I'm not giving anybody credit.
You're discarding my awareness because I'm not giving anyone credit.
My conversation started with you saying, if this place gets run down, and I said, where would you go? You said, I will stay.
Right.
People who are, you would say, in tune, safe. I understood that.
Okay.
I also said, you do realize no one is perfect.
Yes. Well, according to the Bible, the Bible does mention people as being perfect.
Right. You think Jesus Christ is perfect?
Yes.
That's my point. You might not be as aware, right?
So because what did he do that wasn't perfect?
Well, I mean, listen, if you really read, and I have been aware of several different things.
Are you one of those people that believe he committed adultery?
Yeah.
Are you a Lutheran, Mr. Cameroon, brother?
I'm saying he was a human being.
Okay. Well, he did deal with the same temptations as man, but he never succumbed to any of those temptations.
You sound very, your conviction is firm on one side. Mm-hmm. My conviction fluctuates based on the information I'm getting. Right?
Okay. Well,
now, one thing, I trust myself and I believe there's a higher power. But you sound firm on one side. Now, where is that firmness coming from? Just this book that you're reading?
I love that question. I love the question. Before I answer, but because we hopping around a lot.
Yeah.
Let's deal with one thing at a time, right? So let's deal specifically with that, but I'm going to let my brother bring something out right quick. Go ahead.
Yeah, so this is just proof that we actually compiled our own books together. This is the Council of Carthage in 397 AD. It's most well known for establishing a list of the biblical canon, which we have now, or the books of the Bible that are considered accepted. The list included 27 books of the New Testament and 39 books of the Old Testament, which is 66 books, right? Which we have now.
Right.
Now, that council was held in North Africa. All
right.
So those are Africans that literally compiled that text. And then Carthage is well known for having the so-called high Jewish, or we know to be Jew population. So that would be our people.
A group of individuals.
Furthermore, real quick. There was a Ghanaian man who wrote another book called The Africans That Wrote the Bible.
Wow. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So this documented that our ancestors put this Bible together. But just to stay back on that point, if you want to jump back to that later, we can.
It was by holy men.
Okay.
And that's the
key thing, right? So going back to 2 Peter 1:20.
So in your perspective, you seem to have categorized some individuals.
Hold on, let me tell you my firmness. Let me tell you my firmness, right?
We're going to
stay right at the end of time, right? Give me Isaiah chapter 34 and 16. What are you holding?
I'm holding Psalm 68 and 11.
Okay, come on. We'll come back to that. Bring this up. So holy men, it said holy men put the word together. Go ahead.
Leviticus 20 and 26. Uh-huh. And ye shall be holy unto me, For I, the Lord, am holy and have severed you from other people.
Have what?
And have severed you from other people that ye should be mine.
Right, so when he said severed, I've cut you off. You're separate. That's what holy means. So these men that compiled the books together, like the brothers brought out, were holy men. They were set apart men. Hold on 1 second. And then we're going back to 2 Peter to finish it. Go ahead.
2 Peter 1 and 20, knowing this first, that no prophecy of the scripture is of any private interpretation.
Right, so the key thing is prophecy. The reason why this book is above all other books is because the prophecies that are in it. There's no other book. Hold on, wait 1 second.
Book written? One second. Go ahead.
There's no other book. You can't find nothing in the Egyptian books of the hieroglyphics, right. Egyptian Book of the Dead,
right.
The Quran.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? You can read whatever book you want to in this world.
Right.
There's no other book that's going to tell you the history of what happened to our people going into slavery by way of slave ships. You having yokes of iron chains upon your neck.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Your sons and your daughters being stripped from you. Your nationality being taken from you. You being given a new language. You know what I'm saying? You following after your enemy's customs. Those things were prophesied thousands of years ago.
This is a compilation of awareness.
Huh? So Deuteronomy 28.
This is a compilation of awareness. Okay. Right?
Yeah.
So at the end of the day, all I'm saying is this. We don't know, or how long ago is this book written? Let's not say we don't know. Do you know how long ago this book was written?
Over 3,500 years ago, as far as the Torah is concerned.
This is the Torah or this is the Bible?
Well, you had other time periods in which the Bible was compiled together.
Do you believe that human being did not necessarily start from Adam and Eve, which is where this book starts?
Well, it starts at Adam and Eve because they were the chosen, but they had parents. It was people that came before them. But the focus was Adam
and Eve. Let's slow down for a second.
Yeah.
Adam and Eve had parents.
Let's show you. Luke chapter 1 and verse 68. Give me Genesis chapter 3.
What I'm trying to say is philosophies have changed over time. Some buried, some compiled, like in this book. That's what I'm trying to say. But let's find out who Adam and Eve's parents were.
No, I kind of want Genesis 3 where it talks about in the cool of the day. His voice was walking in the cool of the day. Yeah, bring it out. Bring this out for me, Ken.
This is Luke 1 and 68. Blessed be the Lord God of Israel.
Of everybody?
Of Israel. For he have visited and redeemed his people.
So the Lord is going to redeem only his people, the 12 tribes. Go ahead.
Right.
And has raised up an horn of salvation.
Horn of salvation, Jesus the Christ. Go ahead.
For us in the house of his servant David, as he spake by the mouth of his holy prophets.
He did what?
As he spake by the mouth of his holy prophets, which have been since the world began.
Since the what?
Which have been since the world began.
Which have what?
Which have been since the world began.
So the holy prophets have been since the world began. So now give me this. I'm going to show you this.
The prophets have been since the world began.
There was prophets from the very beginning. Now watch this right quick in Genesis chapter 3. Bring it out, or 2, whatever you got.
Genesis chapter 3, verse number 8. And they heard the voice of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day.
In the what?
In the cool of the day.
So look, Adam and Eve heard God's voice walking in the cool of the day. Now what did Adam and Eve do? They sinned against the Most High. Right? So now was God's voice the one that was talking to
Let's
them?
Let's analyze one thing that you said.
Huh?
They sinned against the Most High.
Yes.
Who is that Most High? Was it someone in the sky? Some divine spirit? Or was it somebody who engineered these individuals who sinned against them?
Give me Luke chapter 7 and verse 4. So we're gonna explain that to you through a scripture. Okay?
First of all, let me just say this.
Yes.
You're doing it's like you're soul searching, which is a good thing. Mm-hmm. I'm soul searching as well. The only reason we're having this back and forth is because your conviction comes from a particular book.
Okay.
And I'm saying this is a compilation of information, and we don't even know who the people who compile this information are. But we do. Do you believe that human beings are like a scientific experiment?
Say that one more time.
Do you believe humans are like a scientific experiment? Something that has run, let's not say arrived, but has been running for a long time.
I wouldn't say that they, I mean, everything is
scientific, but yes. It was put together. Do you agree with that?
Yes, it was.
We didn't come from apes.
It was, no,
it was
absolutely
that was
not.
Put together.
No. Yes.
And I don't mean just black people, I mean human beings.
Absolutely. We do believe that.
Okay, so yes. It was put together.
Yes. Genetic
codes.
All of
I bet you God was not in some lab putting genetic codes together. who was that person doing this?
Give me Genesis 1 and 26 like, so I quit. We're going to show you the beginning. Break it out.
Do you believe in people like Anunnaki?
Absolutely not.
Okay.
Watch this real quick. Go ahead.
This is the book of Genesis, chapter 1, verse 26. And God said, let us.
Said, let who?
And God said, let us.
Let me.
Let us.
There's only one divine creator.
Let us make man in our image.
So he says, let us make man in our image, right? So who's the us right here? The us is the Alahayim. Alahayim is the gods.
The gods.
Right. So God is plural, yes.
Okay, who are these people? See, now we are on our way in unison.
Okay, here we go,
Okay, right? Talk to me.
So now, Allah means what?
Means Most High, is that what it is?
God or power, right? Okay. So now, when you say Alahayim, that makes it plural.
Okay.
Right? So that's how you would say, you know, what we just read, right?
Right.
So now, who was that? That was the Most High allowing who the world ignorantly calls Jesus Christ in the Spirit. And the holy angels. They created mankind.
See, you went right. back. That's my point. You went back to the book, which I say is limited information. It's good information,
but
it doesn't have all the information.
Well, so, let me ask you this now. So now, the Bible says that man was created from the dust of the ground.
I believe.
You do believe that?
I mean, granted, you had to use some kind of raw material.
Okay, so yeah, you would agree that the minerals, the same minerals that we found in the dirt, we can find it within the human body, right?
Right.
We can find copper. We can find zinc.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? We can find iron.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? We can find these things in the human body, right? Calcium.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So the Bible says that. So is the Bible on par with how creation, how man grew?
It is on par with that, yeah.
Okay, so but now you show me anywhere where it talks about the Anunnaki.
Show me, brother.
Okay, so that's how do we get to the
Anunnaki? That's why I said, when was this book written? Because man, philosophy, knowledge has come and gone. Some of them lost, right?
Yeah.
And mankind has been alive, has been running for thousands of years. We initially thought BC 5,000 years ago, 10, but now we're going back. Actually, when you really look at fossils, we're back about 25,000 years ago. When we look at pyramids, we initially thought Egypt was like the initial one. But the more we look at fossils, we're going to places like Antarctica. We're finding pyramids in places we did not imagine. We're finding fossils in places we did not. Mankind has not yet found.
Brother, one thing. I see what you're saying. I see your point.
I'm saying this
is what we don't understand.
True.
For the last 5 to 10 minutes, we brought historical documents. Hold on, give me a second. For the last 10 to 5 minutes, we put our biblical truths, right? This brother just told you, scientifically, the dirt, the iron, and all these things, right? Where was your proof at? I haven't heard nothing. Yeah, you're talking. We're actually putting out something. That's all I'm about to say.
Explain
the Anunnaki for us. Explain the Anunnaki.
No, slow down.
Wow.
I don't stand.
So you
get
you're okay.
Now you guys want to discard my awareness. I don't stand here as an expert.
You say I'm a pro.
I'm a pro. What about this? Because like I said initially, I like the idea of soul searching. I am too. But when I hear one of us stand on one premise and say, this is it, I wonder why you would choose one premise. We need cumulative information.
This is the key thing, brother.
We are still searching.
Okay.
Mankind is still searching.
It went over your head earlier.
What went over my head? Tell me.
Prophecy.
Right.
It went over your head. Give me Isaiah 34:16 right quick.
Give me
Deuteronomy 28. We're going
to
go there right there. 68. Hold up, but I got to show you.
The book already. Because you know when we left the book?
We didn't leave
the book. We left the book when you said, God's up.
We're going to show you real quick.
You know why we left the book?
Hold up, wait, brother.
Because I was saying there is an entity. We don't know what. We are still searching.
We're going to show you right now in the Bible. Read this out real quick. 34 and 16.
This is the book of Isaiah chapter 34 and verse 16. Seek ye out of the book of the Lord.
Seek ye out of the book of the Anunnaki.
Seek ye out of the book of the Lord.
Read from the Quran.
Seek ye out of the book of the Lord.
The Egyptian book of the dead.
Seek ye out of the book of the Lord.
Seek out of the Holy Bible, the compiled KJV with the 81 books in it. You know what I'm saying? Or 80. Some say 80. Right, go ahead.
And read.
Do what?
And read.
Skim through it.
And read.
Develop your own interpretation.
And read.
You gotta really read, brother. That's what you gotta do. Go ahead.
No one of these shall fail.
No what?
No one of these shall fail. No
one of these is talking about the prophecies.
Right.
None of them are gonna fail, man. And we're gonna show you a prophecy right now, right? Go ahead.
Deuteronomy 28 and 68. Uh-huh. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again. With ships.
With what?
With ships.
How is the Lord going to bring Israel?
With ships.
So the Most High said he was going to put the Israelites into Egypt again with ships, right? So now, what does that word Egypt mean? It means, it comes from the Greek word Egyptos, meaning bondage, captivity, slavery, or the Hebrew word Matazarium, which means the same thing. So now we know the Israelites walked out of the land of Egypt into the land of Israel. Geographically, those two lands are connected. You don't need a ship to get from Israel to Egypt, right? And they created a man-made Suez Canal. To, you know, now you probably got to do that. But nonetheless, in ancient times, you didn't need that. You know, so but nonetheless, he said, I'm going to send you into Egypt again with ships. So this Egypt is talking about slavery. You substitute Egypt with the word slavery, that's what it's talking about. Now, what people went into slavery by way of slave ships? Historically. As a nation of people, what people went into slavery by way of slave ships?
Top of my head, you would say blacks.
Blacks, right? So let's keep going on this. Go ahead.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships. By the way whereof I spake unto thee, thou shalt see it no more again. And there ye shall be sold unto your enemies.
Unto your what?
Unto your enemies.
Who was we sold to?
Unto your enemies.
For bond men and bond women.
So now I wanna hark back on Egypt, right? Because you look on the back of the dollar bill, you have what? You have a pyramid. You have the all-seeing eye, right? You have a lot of Egyptian architecture.
Symbolism,
right? So now why is it that they have that on the dollar bill? Why is that they have a lot of Egyptian symbolism? I'm going to tell you why, because they know that they have the people of God in their hands.
Right.
They know that they have the Israelites. Hold on.
Did not discard the book.
Okay, but hold on now. Now you're doing some tether babble, man.
No. The book has a lot of truths in it.
Right.
But it's parts of them.
Well, you would have to show us where.
Right.
Show us where the parts are that are not.
No, but I came for a stroll. If I knew you personally, I would spend time finding out what you should look into.
One second. You got the revelation?
Oh, to it. My point is, I respect what you guys are doing.
Okay.
All I'm saying is, and that's why my conversation started with, if something happened, where would you go? Would you admit, if this is us, if this happened to, when we asked who, going into slavery on ship, you said black people. Now we read
the book has a lot of truths in it.
So check this out.
I give credence to the book,
yeah,
but not all the credence to the
right.
book.
Okay, fair
because
enough.
Especially when you say, when we talk of Most High,
yeah,
it's not a spirit.
St. John 6:64.
Bring this up. This is the book of Revelation, chapter 11 and verse 8. And their dead bodies shall lie in the street of the great city, which spiritually is called Sodom and Egypt.
What is this great city called?
Sodom and Egypt.
Right, so this new place where God's chosen people would be in the last days, he said it's going to be like unto Sodom, which represents Sodom and Gomorrah. You know why is that?
Wait, what are you asking me again? Why
so,
the place is called
I'm going to read it one more time. We're going to read it one more time. Watch this.
This is the book of Revelation, chapter 11 and verse 8. And their dead bodies.
There is talking about the Israelites. There's going to be a lot of dead bodies in where?
Shall lie in the street of the great city.
Right. The Israelites are all the people on this sign and scattered beyond. Right, so now you had over 77 million Native Americans that died on the soil. You had over 60 million so-called black people that died on their way over here in the years that have passed. You know what I'm saying? So that's a lot of dead bodies. Right. And this is that great city, right? But we're going to finish.
Which spiritually is called Sodom and Egypt.
So this is not a literal Sodom and Egypt. It's spiritually. Let me finish, Ebenezer. One second. Okay. He said, which is spiritually like Sodom and right. Egypt. So now, why is this place like Sodom?
Why is this place
well,
like
I'm not
Sodom?
Talking, I'm talking about the place that the Bible is referring to right now.
It's talking about a place to be.
Right. So I was like, okay. So yes. Now, what place has created pride events? Mm.
Well, you could say here.
Right.
Oh, you can say here?
Yeah, because
okay, this is, oh, wait, hold on, wait. This is the chief place
right.
of Sodom
right.
and Gomorrah, right? So hold on, wait.
Okay,
so now,
let me ask you this question.
Let me finish that real quick.
I don't want to lose
he
my
said, like,
thought.
Oh, I got you. Okay, hold it. He said, like, Sodom, and then he said, like, Egypt. Now, what happened in ancient Egypt to God's people? Slavery, right?
Okay.
It said brutal slavery. The slave labor, right? So now what happened in America?
Let me ask you this question.
The same exact thing, brother.
It's gotten worse or gotten better?
It's gotten worse. It's definitely gotten worse. I'm gonna tell you why it's gotten worse. Let me tell you why. Ebenezer, I'm gonna tell you why it's gotten worse. Why? Because guess what? America no longer has balance, and not to say that they did 100%, but they don't have balance within any of the systems that you know we see them governing. For instance,
but
right?
How,
hold on, wait. Let me finish. Let me finish. Ebenezer, I'm gonna give you an example. Ebenezer.
No.
Wait. You keep jumping.
I'm not jumping.
But let me finish.
You said it's
I'm gonna answer it.
Please.
Okay. So now, when you look at the music industry. Right, and the people that own the executive people that own the you know these companies and everything, what type of artists and the content in which they're distributing, what type of artists are they putting out to promote to
let's
the people?
Say,
hold on, wait,
worst.
I'm gonna give
they
you one. Sexy Red.
Right.
Is Sexy Red a benefit,
no.
or is she going opposite of what is deemed to be righteous?
It kind of depends on how you choose to want to look at it.
Okay, so now
let me say this.
So what you like about Sexy Red?
I don't like anything about I didn't say I like Sexy Red.
All right, brother, but you see how it's repetitive? You see Ice Spice? Is she any better than Sexy Red?
But I know
we just seen the BET Awards. We were just there.
I know back in the day, the women were used as sex slaves.
Absolutely. Okay. And we see those same things presently today.
But to a lesser degree.
Yes, to a lesser degree.
Bingo.
But it's still
okay,
the same thing.
Worse.
No, brother.
Like, brother,
I'm gonna tell you how it's
the
worse
angel
though.
Progresses,
but look,
and the enemy does too.
I'm gonna tell you.
Your enemy gets better at dealing with you just like
she
you get
trying
better.
To hit
but
us.
Check this out, brother.
Hit
check
her.
This out. But look,
you don't want to be on camera.
The enemy progresses just like the ally does. Yes?
Absolutely.
Okay then. So back in the day, they were using maybe the ladies as sex slaves. Today,
physically.
They make her a celebrity and
yes.
have her promote. But keep in mind.
But guess who's taking in all of that promotion?
Whoever
the
is
youth,
smart.
The youth, who are they promoting it to? It's all of the people on this side right here, brother.
There will always be
so
an idiot.
You see how the manipulation is going?
There will always
that's
be
way worse, man. Because now you got what? Social media. And nothing but social media is being flooded with images of Sexy
and
Red, Ice Spice, Cardi B.
I respect what you're saying.
You see what I'm saying?
And I understand what you're saying. But I also know there is a good part of the population that is not
who
with
got Isaiah
that.
17 and 15?
And if they're not with that, they are progressing. Not everybody believes Ice Spice and all these people are great.
See,
a lot of them are listening to them. But the opportunity to make an informed decision is present. Something that did not exist before. Before, you were given the road to walk, you walked it, and that's all you knew. Today, there's information everywhere. If you're a fool and you choose to listen to the dumb information, well,
but
guess
see,
what?
Some people
just
don't
like the
know
devil,
about it,
the
bro.
Devil will give right. you... The devil will give you what you need.
I'm going to tell you what you're doing yourself. Right now, Ebenezer. We got Isaiah 17 and 15. Get that for me right quick. Brother, give me Isaiah 17 and 15. Bring this out right quick.
This is John 6 and 64. Red letters. But there are some of you that believe not. For Yahweh Shai knew from the beginning who they were.
He's most high.
What was wrong with what he was reading?
Proverbs 17 to 15.
You aborted it. What was wrong with what he was reading? You aborted
That's not exactly what I wanted, right? Four, bring it up.
Okay. It's the book of John, chapter 4, 24. God is a spirit, And they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth.
Read it one more time.
God is a spirit.
What is the Most High?
God is a spirit.
No, it's the Anunnaki.
God is a spirit. And they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth.
Right. So this is actually what I wanted. Just a couple verses up.
One verse up. This is John 6 and 63. It is the spirit that quickeneth, the flesh profited nothing. The words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life.
They are what?
They are life.
They are spirit and they are life. Bring this up.
2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse number 17. Now the Lord is that spirit.
Is it the what?
Now the Lord is that spirit.
He's no spirit.
Now the Lord is that spirit. And where the spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty.
There is liberty in that spirit. So the Lord is a spirit. You know what I'm saying? So we got you on that. You're looking found at that. Hold on, one second. We got one scripture for you. Okay. Watch it. This is what you're doing right here. So this is. Ebenezer, this is where you're going off at. I'm going to show you. On this next scripture. Watch this. Go ahead.
This is the book of Proverbs, chapter 17, verse 15.
Bring it up.
He that justifieth the wicked.
He that doeth what?
He that justifieth the wicked.
What is saying things that progress here in America?
He that justifieth the wicked.
What's saying that sexy? I don't have an issue with sexy red.
He that justifieth the wicked.
What's wrong with saying, you know, they're paying millions of dollars to these rappers to come out of the projects and they're living a lot better now?
He that justifieth the wicked.
You are justifying the wickedness of the white race.
Right.
That's what you're doing, Ebenezer. We're going to finish the scripture. Go ahead.
We're going to
finish it real fast. Go ahead.
Make me lose my train of thought.
Go ahead, Ebenezer.
Have any of you lived anywhere else in the world?
Yes.
What is that? You lived in Japan. He's from Haiti.
Okay. So you lived in Haiti?
Yes.
In other places, and you would say you are in a worse place now than before?
Answer, because tell us how Japan was, brother.
No, Japan is better than here.
Japan is better than here.
Yeah.
So you went to, did you come here to preach the word of God?
No, I live there because my mom is from there.
Say that again.
My mom is from there.
But you live here?
Mm-hmm.
Your mom is there or your mom is here?
No, she's here now, yeah.
Okay, so you guys intentionally left a better place for a worse place?
No, it's because I was born here, but
well,
I
your
lived
mother.
Here
she yeah. intentionally packed up well, and said,
"Is she not moving back next year?"
She's moving back
next year.
She's moving back.
But after how long? She's moving back for a good reason. She's gotten what she came for.
Okay, let's say this. Off of the backs of who? Of the people that built this place. Nobody would be able to come over here had it not been for the so-called black people that built America.
Right.
Nobody would be able to come over here and thrive and have a good time and walk up and down Santa Monica had it not been for the slaves.
You
understand that, Ebenezer?
No, let's agree. Despite how strong you are, brute force is irrelevant without the right management, correct? It doesn't matter what the skin color of the manager is. Are you able to manage appropriately?
So show me.
Now. I'm not saying I'm leaning to the left as in whoever. I don't know who managed the project. I know we are talking about these people suffering for the project. Not ghetto. I mean, like, you know, when you're working on the project, you know. Management is still very important.
Well, brother.
You just left Japan. No matter how good they look, I know Asian countries. I don't trust Asian countries. Right?
We you trust COVID. Only white countries. No. We know Ebenezer. We know.
Regarding my awareness. And you're going for a lame response.
No, brother, go ahead.
Honestly.
We listen to you. But you still have to agree, brother.
You think I'm saying white is better.
Brother, would America have existed had not the slaves built this place?
Let me say this. I'm not
just answer
white
that one question for me. Would America have existed had it not been for the slaves that
Bring
built this place?
That out. Let's say no. No, I'm saying let's say no, right?
No,
it is no.
Why? It is straight up no.
Why? My question is, why was one person able to manage such a project while
one
the
person?
Other people, let's say where we came from, are not making or conceptualizing or constructing a similar project? What is going on with
that? I'm going to tell you this. Check this out.
Monkey see, monkey do.
I got you right here. I'm going to answer.
Why am I not copying?
I'm going to answer.
And why were you...
Brother Ebenezer.
Let me just finish this sentence.
Go ahead.
Why were you more aware of what to do and how to put it together? Why was your math
better than my man. And we're all sitting here thinking, now granted, you could say it's because of A, B, and C. You could say the people went to New York and said they didn't think, the Indians didn't think you could buy the skies and things of that nature. Meanwhile, some people were conceptualizing like, yeah, I'll give you 20 cents and I'll buy all this land. No one thought land belonged to a human being.
But you say you're from Cameroon, right?
I am.
Cameroon.
Correct.
Why did you leave?
For a better opportunity.
Okay. So you're saying that their mathematics wasn't accurate as the white
people. Goddamn right. Other people.
Okay.
Goddamn right.
So
even Russia's mathematics is not good. It's all white people over there.
Yeah.
Even Russia's math is not good. Even Japan's math is not good. Even Chinese math is not good. There's a reason certain people had the wherewithal.
We're going to show you why the white man.
It's not just
hold on,
the white
give
man.
Me a second, brother.
It's not just. It's not about
who colonized the
man.
Earth.
That's my point.
Who colonized? Because colonizing the mathematics.
That's why.
If I can control your resources and control everything your land, then I got the mathematics. I'm on the seat. I'm on the political seat.
Some people, there was a personality, an entity, which was more aware. Now who? He gave its information to, let me ask this question.
The white man has directly
When you say the white man, it nullifies the information you're trying to achieve.
Because they have directly sabotaged other people from thriving as society, as country.
I know that.
Indirectly. I'm gonna give you an example though. I'm gonna give you an example. Rosewood, I'm gonna give you Tulsa, Oklahoma. You got five. But I'm making my point right now.
Sure.
You know what I'm saying? Because look, you have five survivors from Tulsa, Oklahoma, over 100 years ago, in which they directly sabotage a thriving community in
Tulsa,
Oklahoma.
Human beings will do that.
But what human beings did it?
Do that.
Brother, what human beings did it?
What Russia is doing to me.
Brother, wait, don't dance around. What human beings directly sabotage the thriving community of Tulsa, Oklahoma, of Rosewood?
Yeah, they're white neighbors.
You said white what?
They're white neighbors.
White people did it, right? So check this out. It's a repetitive history that we're seeing in the earth right now, in which white people are going to other places, colonizing, and taking people for their resources.
Right. Parts of the world, my friend.
Are they not doing that in other parts of the world?
Thank you. They are.
Of course they are.
Of the same skin color. They do the same thing.
So why are you sitting here justifying their evil?
I'm not justifying anyone's evil.
Yes, you are.
I just said we need a lot of information before we read from one book and chastise. Let me ask you this question. Is your conversation here to point fingers at a white person?
No, absolutely not.
Because that's what it seems like you're doing.
No,
because you're discarding everything I'm saying to say,
Job 21 and 31. I'm going to show you right quick. The chief thing that we come out here to do
Please. Is
tell blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans that they are God's chosen people. They
Beautiful.
Need to repent.
And
God is going to destroy this place, and you're going to get destroyed with it unless you repent, and you can get salvation.
Right.
That's the chief thing. You see what I'm saying? So, but now, check this out. But in the midst of doing that, we will tell a person this to their face. Right, go ahead.
Job 21 and 31. Who shall declare his way to his face?
So the Bible is saying, who's going to declare his way to his face? We do. The Lord set us up to tell him about his evil ways directly to his face.
Right.
And who shall repay him what he have done?
Right. And who's going to repay him what he have done? The Lord is going to repay him.
Right.
And we tell him his judgment to his face.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
So,
right,
give me this wisdom of Solomon 5:1.
Like what they call a case study. So this is a specific narrative. This is a specific narrative.
Okay.
Right here. That's pretty much what you're doing. And
specific
I appreciate it, but
yeah.
It's specific. You're saying we don't really mind all the other philosophies. We are focused on this philosophy right now.
We're focused on this people, it's not a philosophy. You know what I'm saying? But we're focused on these people as a nation.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? And we're giving back our heritage that was stolen from us.
Right. Okay. But we do recognize that whatever happened to these people happens to other people of the same skin color in other places. Yes?
Yes, but if
okay.
they but
okay.
if,
That's if, where I'm coming from.
If they don't come from the same lineage as us, we couldn't care less.
But they do.
Not all of them.
They do.
Not all of them.
When you go to places like, let's say Africa.
Let's say Africa.
The neighbor lynches
his
neighbor.
Somebody have images of Canaan.
When you go to places, let's say Africa, the neighbor lynches his neighbor. What would you say about that?
Well, I would say, you know, what tribe in Africa are they from? That's a key thing to ask. Black. Are they from the Ashanti tribe? You know what I'm saying? Are they from
different tribes?
Aruba?
Different tribes.
But I have to ask that, the Bantu tribes, because those would be our people. But if they come from certain other tribes, that would not be considered our people. Because look,
So what you're saying is, huh? Some blacks are not our people.
Absolutely.
Some blacks are not our people.
Francis, I'm gonna give you an example.
So when you say American blacks who might have come from, let's say, different parts of the world.
No, we came from West Africa.
So let's say they came from West Africa. West Africa has people in West Africa who lynch neighboring towns.
Yes.
Bantu or Hutus and all that. That's South Africa, I believe, if I'm not mistaken. Nonetheless, blacks killing blacks. So you're saying those who do the killing are not our people?
I wouldn't say that. We know our people have an evil eye, and we do evil things in the earth as well. However, yes, that's a curse. You know what I'm saying? That God said what happened to our people. However, it's still about lineage.
So who's lineage?
Romans chapter 8. We'll come back then. Romans 8, 16.
I have a cousin.
Yes.
I love him. He recently died not long ago. I found out there's a war going on in West Africa. Of Cameroon War. This person, who is a great person, was a spokesperson for the war. And you know what that war was doing? That war was killing pregnant women, castrating people. You would not believe the person standing next to you is capable of certain things. So I say that to say this. No one is perfect. At the end of the day, the person died. We still appreciate them for what they invested into us while they were alive. And we did a funeral service, may their souls rest in peace. But collecting information is very important because we don't know who is who.
Well, we can stand and point fingers
at one person, right. But the person who kills you is not necessarily that person. Back in the day, things happened. Of course, we are all working towards a better tomorrow.
I don't think everybody is, but I'm going to hit you with something. Right. Check this out, because I know there are Israelites, my people, in Cameroon. You know what I'm saying? But this is a clear distinction of two different nationalities of people. You have one on the right hand that is of the lineage of Ham, according to the Bible, which Ham is the forefather or progenitor of dark races such as the Ethiopians, the Libyans, the Canaanites, and the Egyptians.
Okay.
Right on the left side, that is somebody who comes from the lineage of Shem. He's a Shemite, right? Which he is the father of the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native American Indians. He is the father of other groups as well, but you have to come directly from Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob to be of that chosen lineage. Because there's other Shemites in the world.
Right.
Arabs are Shemites.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? If I'm not mistaken, Amalek, Jewish people are Shemites. You know what I'm saying? But the people in which God chose to be his near and dear people above all the other groups in the earth, they from Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. And those of us that were scattered in small portions in places like Ethiopia, in places like South Africa, in places like Cameroon,
Ghana.
So
this is 2024, and to lean on hierarchy, bloodline hierarchy.
Yes.
Don't you think that kills the conversation that, say, a person like Obama was trying to preach? About it not long ago, saying, what did he say? He said, I believe, Martin Luther said, I believe Obama, who was saying, we can be one in some way, shape, or form. Talk hierarchy. So many people can say, oh, my bloodline is A, B, and C, right? So many people, listen, this is a small group of individuals between us. There are many groups that will come with their own reasons of why they should be superior.
Well, I mean, we go off the word of God.
Right?
Do you have that? Bring it up.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 7, verse 6. Ebenezer, you seem like you're pretty smart. We showed you what holy means, right?
We spoke of holy.
We showed you with the Bible.
We spoke.
Okay, so this is Deuteronomy 7 and 6. For thou art holy people, meaning separate, set apart. God severed those people. For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God. The Lord thy God has chosen thee to be a special people unto himself, above.
Equal to?
Above.
Everybody's working towards the same goal.
Above.
Everybody wants to sing Kumbaya and be all equal together.
Above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
Right, so that's God's word. Hey, and we stand on that, man. It's no equality with God, man. It's no equality with that, Ebenezer. Watch this right quick, Ebenezer. This is the definition of hand. Watch it.
Let me say something before you go. Let me say something before you go. Just yesterday, I was having a conversation with my auntie, and we were talking about presidential debates. She turned to me, she said, back home, some people still will call you out for coming from a slave lineage. This is the Africans arguing with each other about who's going to be president. And if your ancestors used to be slaves, not slaves to a white person, slaves to in that community, you trying to be a president in present day, some elders will be aware of where you started or where your lineage started, and they will use that against you in a presidential election. So here we are in 2024, where, and I asked her, I said, so you mean my financial capabilities, my awareness, my abilities, and all the resources I've garnered over my life would not matter because my bloodline, for example, would have come from maybe a slave general, a slave beginning.
Yes, and that lets you know that it's a difference between those two groups.
Right.
That's a key
that
point.
That is the difference, but my point is that right or wrong?
It's definitely wrong, but that lets you know that it's a difference.
It's wrong because it's 2024.
Right. But people are always going to be have differences based off of lineage. It's always going to be that way.
And people would want to claim that. But the little child being born, when we look at a little child, we say it's innocent because we are hoping he's going to come up with a better perspective.
Okay.
A better premise.
So now, would Jesus want everybody together?
What do you think? I think so. What do you think?
Luke 12:51, right quick. Let's get Matthew 25:31 right quick. Let's find out about the Lord Jesus Christ, shall we?
Now we're going to go back to the book of Luke, chapter 12, verse 51.
It's
not perfect.
Hey, this is all red letters.
Just human. This is all red letters. What did he say? This is red letters.
Luke 12:51. Suppose ye that I ain't come to give peace on earth. I tell you nay.
What did Christ say?
I tell you nay. But rather division.
What does Christ want?
But rather division.
He wants everybody together.
Say it again.
This is Luke 12:51.
Thumbs down to you guys, devils.
Suppose ye that I am come to give peace on earth. I tell you nay, but rather division.
Christ wants division.
You know why?
Why does he want division?
I know why he wants division.
Why?
Because I want to separate who's in and who's out.
Let's
I
find
want to
out.
Separate who's good and who's bad.
Well, let's find
I want
out.
To separate who's progressive.
Let's get Matthew 15:24 right quick. Bring this out, okay?
I want to separate those who are using their heads
31.
From those who are not.
This is the book of Matthew chapter 25 verse 31. When the Son of Man shall come in his glory, and all the holy angels with him.
Right. The Alahayim, they're coming in their glory. And all the holy angels with him, Christ.
Then shall he sit upon the throne of his glory.
When all these kingdoms is casted down, America's been destroyed, Russia's no longer a power, China's no longer a power, Christ, HaMashiach, who the world ignorantly calls Jesus, Yahawashah in the Hebrew tongue, is going to sit upon his throne. Go ahead.
And before him shall be gathered all nations.
Before him is going to be gathered all nationalities of people, right? Go ahead.
And he shall separate.
He's going to do what?
He shall separate.
He's going to keep them together.
He shall separate.
Christ wants everybody to be in unison.
He shall separate them from one another.
Right, he's going to separate them one from another.
Stop it for a second. When I say everybody goes straight, this is a lame example, but listen to it.
We gotta keep reading. I know, I see where you're going.
Let me just say something. If I tell a crowd of people, everyone goes straight down this road, do you believe everybody's just gonna go straight down that road?
So you're saying everybody's not gonna listen to Jesus?
Which is where comes the division. He wants whoever is speaking in there is saying, I'm gonna have a philosophy. I believe not everyone will follow.
right? And at that time, I will separate friend from foe.
Brother, you shooting from the hip right now, man.
Right.
That's what you're doing right
That's
now. You're shooting from the hip. You got blanks. It's not working out for you right now. But we're going to finish Jesus' words. You're winging it right now. We're going to finish Jesus' words. Go ahead.
I'm sorry. And he shall separate them from another as the shepherd divided his sheep from the goat.
What?
As a shepherd divided his sheep from the goat.
Who is Christ's sheep?
What would you say? The people who are aligned with Christ?
You said the people that are aligned with Christ, right? Matthew 15 and 24.
I said aligned. He pointed over here. Okay. I said aligned. He pointed over here. What do you think it is?
Okay,
aligned.
We're going to read it. We're going to read it. This is Matthew 15 and 24. But he answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
Who did Christ say he was sent to?
I am not sent. But unto the lost sheep.
Unto the lost what?
Unto the lost sheep.
Unto the lost what?
Unto the lost sheep.
He said, I'm going to divide the sheep from the goats. He said, but I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of who?
Of the house of Israel.
Well, anybody's of the, you know, the lost sheep.
Of the house of Israel.
He said he was only sent to the lost sheep. If you're not
here. If you're not here, you cannot be. According to the Bible, you cannot be saved.
Absolutely. Right. You got it, Ebenezer.
Right. You got it, Ebenezer.
This is the book of Jeremiah, chapter 51 and verse 6. Flee out of the midst of Babylon.
What?
Flee out of the midst of Babylon.
So I think I want 50 and 6. Bring this
50 and 6.
This is Revelation. This is the kingdom of heaven where everybody wants to get to. Revelation 21 and 12. And out of wall, great and high, and had 12 gates.
How many gates does the kingdom of heaven have?
And had 12 gates.
It's one big gate everybody going to walk through.
And had 12 gates. And at the gates, 12 angels.
12 angels, go ahead.
And names written thereof.
Got what?
And names written thereon.
What these gates got written on?
And names written thereon, which are the names of the 12 tribes of the children of Israel.
Oh, no, the Italians is in there.
Of the children of Israel.
Oh, the Dutch is in there.
Of the children of Israel.
Where the Portuguese at?
Of the children of Israel.
But the Irish got to be in there.
Of the children of Israel.
But the Spaniards got to be in there.
Of the children of Israel.
And what about the white man?
Of the children of Israel.
Hey, the white man. Man, they ain't gonna make it, man!
Hey!
You got it, Ebenezer. You got it.
But what I'm saying is this.
And the fire trucks.
So how did we move forward? How are we moving forward then?
Y'all not gonna make it, man.
That's what I mean.
But y'all don't wanna make it, man. I believe y'all don't wanna make it.
No, no. Let me tell you why.
I do like
Let me
you
tell you
because
why.
You did figure it out.
I like
right.
You. I was listening. We kept hitting you.
I was listening.
But maybe that's where we misunderstood each other. Maybe that's where we misunderstood each other. No.
Isaiah
before you go,
29 and 12.
Before we proceed there.
Yes.
So you mean to tell me that you and I will discard the efforts of the next man? With everything we know in 24, the Bible will make you and I do what, say, the Muslims do. Kill people in the name of Allah. Is that what you're telling me? That despite everything we know, we would read the Bible and say, okay, you are white-skinned, fuck you. Is that what we're doing? Because that's what the Muslims do. The Muslims say, oh, Allah says we should blow this place because they're infidels. Here goes a bomb. Boom. They're not. Meanwhile, you and I, when we saw the trade centers go down, we looked at the trade centers and said, this is not right. We saw the trade centers go down and we said, this is not right. They sat on their end of the world and said, this is based on what Allah wants us to do. We are sitting over here and you're telling me that we have 12 people.
Ebenezer.
We are going to let
Ebenezer.
Start everybody else's place.
Ebenezer.
Everyone else's place.
Ebenezer. How did you go from what we read to us doing terrorist acts? You're not. You mentioned World Trade Centers.
You didn't listen to me. I said, we have a notion which came from a book. And despite everything we know, we are going strictly with the letters in the book. We have discarded everything we are aware of, which is the fact that I am and I want to be my brother's keeper. whoever my brother is.
No.
Well, I understand. So if I'm working hand in hand with any race who has had my back, has shown nothing but loyalty, I will discard him because the Bible tells me to do
it. Yes, give me
a...
Does that make sense?
Sirach chapter
6,
verse
12
and
10.
But does that make sense?
Yes, sure. Chapter 12 and verse 10. Never trust thy enemy.
What the Lord said?
Never trust thy enemy.
He gave me a pack of smokes one time.
Never trust thy enemy.
Like, I love a pack of squares, don't you?
Never trust thy enemy.
We watched a movie. We had a movie night together.
Never trust thy enemy.
Look, man, we went shopping together.
Never trust thy enemy.
He's my best friend.
Never trust thy enemy.
I grew up with.
Never trust thy enemy.
Same community.
Never trust thy enemy. For like as iron rusteth, so is his wickedness.
Right, so is his wickedness. You got something?
That microphone right there. I don't know how well you know the history of Haiti, right?
Not as well, but you know, I know a little bit. Let me say that.
Just trying to make a point. The guy named Jean-Jacques Dessalines. He was fighting, you know, back to back with Alexander Pinto.
Another powerful leader, yes.
Okay. That was his buddy.
Okay.
And you know later who he told him?
No, that
was Alexander Pinto.
So he was betrayed by, are you going to say a white skinned individual?
He was a light skinned, his dad was white. His mom was a Haitian woman.
Now, don't let me take too much more of you guys' time. But you do and are aware of black-on-black crime.
No, yeah. I don't.
Okay.
It was
when you point fingers at someone who has done nothing to you, you know what they say, keep your enemies close, keep your friends close, keep your enemies closer, right?
No,
I get exactly what you...
It is a worldly quote because we're speaking to an extent superficial. I didn't come with facts. You're reading up a book that I have, to an extent, discarded its depth.
No, I get exactly what you're saying, though. It was not only Alexander Pinto alone that come together. You get stabbed in the back
by so many different people.
You know, crime is in the Bible?
I would imagine. The Bible is a very...
Just look. Even outside of that, you know it's white on white crime, right?
Right.
You know wherever a person lives, whoever you're closest to, you're going to commit crimes against them. If I go to Chinatown, it's Chinese on Chinese crime.
That's why I don't qualify to say who goes through the gates.
Well, the Bible, I mean, we write out the Bible.
And that's why I brought up, the Trade Center. Because I said, like the Muslim says, these people over here are infidels. Let's bomb them because they are worthy to. You are saying these skins are not like us, or at least are not in these 12. So regardless of the heart, regardless of the effort, regardless of the person, fuck that. The Bible tells me not to trust that. So fuck all that. Meanwhile,
Real quick, because you said they didn't do this. The white people that's alive didn't do none of this, right?
No, that's not what I'm saying. What I'm saying is, I can only judge things based on the experiences I go through.
Right.
You show me love, I show you love. If we have a conducive working relationship, respect that.
Based off of history, though?
Right. That's wrong.
How is that wrong? To go based off of history.
Like, things change. People change. People evolve. Let's check this out.
Ebenezer, real fast.
Because if that's the case, then you might as well just go white.
Ebenezer, let's do a 70-year difference right now, right? 1955, Emmett Till. He allegedly whistled at a white woman. Right?
She's still living too.
She just passed away last year. She was 95 years old, right? So now, he allegedly whistled at a white woman, and that's what happened to him eventually. This was his end outcome. Burned alive, you know what I'm saying? Tortured, you know what I'm saying? So and they eventually
before,
what?
Before, after.
Yes, before, after. So now, and then,
fast forward,
even, actually I wanted to bring up Juwan Charles, I believe his name was. But you could do Rasheem Carter. He was hunted down by three white men. He called his mother on the phone to let her know what was happening at that present time. He said, went to the police station. And he said, look, it's three white men following me. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, he didn't know what to do in that particular moment, but they caught up with him and killed him and castrated him and mutilated his body.
Right.
That is a 70-year difference.
2023. Right.
This is going on in present-day America.
It's also going on in present-day Africa.
All right, dude. Look, we're dealing with our people, man. Yeah. I can't specify what's happening to the tribes in Africa.
So I say we should keep ourselves open to a possibility of difference. Because if not, you close the gates and you say, you know what? I know everything I need to know. I don't need to listen anymore. The Bible has told me so.
We do keep ourselves open. Check this out. Hold on. Wait. Check this out. Ebenezer, check this out. You know what else is still going down?
Fuck you guys.
We don't care about you, devil.
Fuck you
guys. We don't care about you, devil. Hey, die today, devil.
Come on, bitch.
Die today, devil.
Come on, bitch.
You're on your last breath, man.
Come on, bitch.
Your eyes are sucking in, man.
Fuck
you. You're on your last breath.
Fuck all
you. Hey, die today, devil. Die today. Shut your snagger tooth ass, man. Shut your snagger tooth ass up, man. Yeah, go put your teeth in so we can better hear you, man. We don't understand what you're saying, devil. Right? And it is, hey, look, this is the same people that you're talking about that you're trying to save right now. Ebenezer, the Lord did this right now. The Lord brought the demon up here to show you that they hate us with a perfect hatred, man.
Come on, Ebenezer.
The Lord did that for you, man. The Lord did that for you, Ebenezer. Don't you edit that out, Ebenezer.
I wouldn't.
Can I show you something, brother?
Sure.
This is currently sundown towns in America. Are you familiar with the term sundown towns?
Not necessarily.
Sundown towns are basically towns where if a black, so-called black person or Hispanic was to come to their town when the sun goes down.
Or be in that town when the sun goes down.
You will be in big trouble.
Purge.
This is current sundown towns in America right now. Right now, look how red it is. Look how red it is. So, no, these people, no, they the devil, bro.
You give them time. Yes,
it's certain places we cannot be in America. If you driving through the country, black people know they have documents or websites black people, other black people can go to know where to go to and where not to go to.
So why don't, if you are so, if you're I appreciate everything I heard. Right? Because understand, I'm learning as well.
I know where you're going. Wisdom of Solomon 5:1. Give me Psalms 91. Go ahead.
Keep it ready.
Yes, I'm gonna keep it ready.
If you know what you know,
yes,
and you are staunch and firm.
Yes. Why don't I leave? Ebenezer, why don't I get up out of here? Huh? You know why? Because God said this was our land, man. That's one. God said this was our land. We built this country up. You know what I'm saying? Watch this right quick. And this is also going to answer your question. Go ahead.
This is Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 5 and verse 1. Then shall the righteous man...
Wait, we're going to do it slowly. Then shall the what?
Then shall the righteous man...
What are we?
Righteous man.
Righteous men up here. He said, then shall the righteous man... Go ahead.
Stand in great boldness before the face of such as have afflicted him.
Right. We stand in great boldness in the face of such as have afflicted us. Right, just like the man that walked up just now and flipped us all, gave us the bird, you know what I'm saying, and said all type of obscenities. My name is Shalomar.
Shalomar.
Yeah. Wait, let us finish first. Ebenezer. Right, so hey, brother, hold it down right quick. I need you on that precept. Go ahead.
And made no account of his labor.
They make no account of all our labors, man. They have not gave us any type of reparations, you know what I'm saying? Restitution for what we did in building this country up. They did it for the $5 Indians. They did it for the Japanese. They did it for the Chinese. They did it for the Italians. They did it for the Irish. But they have not did it for the people upon this earth. You see what I'm saying? But go ahead.
When they see it.
When they see what?
When they see it.
They see our salvation. They're going to see us being delivered up out of this place. Go ahead.
When they see it, they shall be troubled with terrible fear.
It's going to come upon white people.
they shall be troubled with terrible fear.
What's the confused look on this devil's face?
They shall be troubled with terrible fear.
They're going to be troubled with terrible fear. It's going to be dreadful, Ebenezer. Go ahead.
And shall be amazed at the strangeness of his salvation.
Say, that's a strange salvation, right? Go ahead.
So far beyond all that they have looked for.
Because it's not in their hearts to believe that they're going to be saved. White people are in their heaven right now.
Right.
The Chinese are in their heaven right now.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? All these other nations, and the Arabs is in their heaven right now. Everybody. We're the only ones in hell right now.
Good.
Go ahead.
Verse 3, and they repenting and groaning for anguish of spirit shall say within themselves.
These other nations are going to say within themselves as they see us being delivered and taken up out of Babylon, the great America. Go ahead.
This was he whom we had sometimes in derision.
They have?
We had sometimes in derision.
They're going to look up and see us being taken up, and they're going to be like, man, we had these people in derision. We had them confused. We had them not knowing their true heritage. We had them believing that America was, hey, 4th of July.
Right.
You had on your, hey, we made them wear the red, white, and blue.
Right.
We made Ebenezer believe America was the greatest place on earth.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Go ahead.
And a proverb of reproach.
We had songs about niggas, man. You know what I'm saying? We say an elevator can raise a family,
right,
but a black man can't.
Right.
Yeah, they got proverbs about us, right? You know what I'm saying?
Backbone of the family.
Yeah, yeah. Proverbs about black people, right? Go ahead.
We fools.
We what?
We fools.
When they see us getting delivered up out of here and we came back to our true heritage, we said we're going to keep the commandments of God. We said this is the only thing that we are supposed to believe, and we're going to get delivered up out of here. Wait, we're almost done. Go ahead.
We fools accounted his life madness.
They look at us right now and say, these they ain't got nothing better to do. They ain't got no job. They just out here
right.
on a Saturday and just yelling at people. But they counted our lives as being madness, man. You know what I'm saying? But you got brothers up here that done been through hell and back in the Most High, have delivered from them.
Right.
You got brothers up here that got their own business out here.
Right.
You got brothers out here that work full-time jobs, man.
Right.
Brothers that's going to school, man.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Looking to graduate real soon. Go ahead.
And his end to be without honor. How is he numbered among the children of God and his lot among the saints?
Right, they're going to think and be like, man, he's really one of the people of God, man. And his number is among one of those that was chosen and elected to rule in the kingdom of heaven. We got one more scripture and I got you. Go ahead, bring it out. 91 and 5.
This is the book of Psalms, chapter 91, verse 5. Uh-huh. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, uh-huh, nor for the arrow that flieth by day.
Nor for the what?
Nor for the arrow that flies by day.
So look, it's going to be terrifying pretty soon in America what's going to happen.
Right.
Because like we said, it's going to be America's going to be destroyed by thermonuclear missiles. They just made it passed a bill for all 18 to 25-year-olds in Congress. You're going to be drafted into this next world's war. You ain't got no say-so. Men and women. Right now, I think they got men confirmed. They're still debating on whether or not they're going to do it. But they're going to do it with the women. You know what I'm saying? We're going to finish. We got you.
Russian warships,
yeah, Cuba,
nuclear submarine frigates,
yeah,
that came 90 miles off the coast of Florida,
yeah, we gonna keep going.
Cuba and Venezuela.
And they're practicing right now.
Yeah.
Yeah, they rehearsing, right? But we're going to finish real quick, Ebenezer.
Do you believe in things unseen?
Well, let me finish this and I'll get to you that. I'll get to that.
This is verse 6. Nor for the pestilence that walketh in the darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday.
It's going to happen at any point of the any time of the day. The Most High can bring this judgment. Go ahead.
Verse 7. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 shall and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee.
It shall what?
It shall come nigh
thee. It shall what?
But it shall not come nigh thee.
Right, so all the destruction that's going to happen in America, God said it's not going to touch my elect.
Real.
It's not going to touch none of my righteous men and women in these last days. Go ahead.
Verse 8.
Only
with thine eyes shalt thou behold and see the reward of the wicked. Verse 9. Because thou hast made the Lord
which is my refuge.
Which is my what?
Which is my refuge.
What is he to us?
Which is my refuge.
The Most High is our refuge and hedge of protection. Go ahead.
Even the Most High thy habitation.
So the Most High is going to protect us from all of the said destruction that's to come. Okay, but, you know what I'm saying?
Now let me ask you this. Do you believe in things unseen?
Yeah. Do I believe in things unseen? That's, yeah. That's,
if you have a dream for the future that is not present.
I'm going to ask you with this scripture right here.
Before you read that, let's not read that yet, but just tell me something as a person. As a human being, you have a dream for the future that is not current. Like being a slave, for example, wishing for a brighter day. Operate in that initial premise, or do you operate in your premise or your experience to come?
I'm a slave right now wishing for a better day.
Bingo. So do you operate just based on today? For example, if I'm struggling, going through hard times, and I have a lot of reasons to complain,
yes.
Do I spend my time complaining about what's hurting me now, or do I try to mold my personality for what I want to come tomorrow?
Yeah, we do a lot of works to try to make our situation better, but ultimately, this is the key thing.
Go ahead. Just tell me, do you mold your personality for what is to come? For example, I want to be an artist.
Okay.
Do I spend my time writing, honing my skills?
This is why this is the perfect scripture for you right here.
Or do I say, you know what, I'm broke right now and I have no money, and just say, screw it?
Right. This is the perfect scripture for you. I got you right here.
But as a person, though, I would imagine you try to move forward. Yes?
2 Corinthians 4:17. For our light affliction, which is but for a moment.
For our light affliction, which is but for a moment, right? What we going through right now, the Most High said, hey, look, it's really light affliction at the end of the day. The Most High said it's going to feel like a dream when we get taken up out of here. Light affliction. Go ahead.
Worketh for us a far more exceedingly an eternal weight of glory.
Right, so even in our light affliction, we are understanding that this, what we're going through, it works a more exceeding and eternal weight of glory, meaning we have a prize coming at the end with all of the stuff that we're going through. Next verse, go.
Verse 18. Why we look not at the things which are seen.
What does the Bible say?
Why we look not at the things which are seen.
He said, do I believe in things unseen, right? That was one of the questions, right? That we just read, why we look not at the things which are seen. Go ahead.
Right.
Why we look not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen.
Which are what?
Which are not seen.
We look at the things. Hold on. We're going to finish it. We look at the. Okay, go ahead.
So, Would you like to lead the people to the promised land?
I like to lead the descendants of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob to the promised land.
That's right.
So, it's
see, it all goes back.
So, in other words, like someone would say, you're like some people. This is not you. Some people would say, oh, you're racist. Some people would say, oh, you're biased. So, when it comes to leading people to the promised land, you don't want everybody to come.
Well, no, I do.
Even
these two people right here, I need them to be my slaves.
Right.
That's what I need them to do. Right? And the Lord said they're going to be my slaves.
Right.
So, I need all of these. Give me Isaiah 14:1 right quick.
So you want slaves?
The Bible says I'm going to have slaves.
Every empire has slaves, brother.
Yes, exactly.
Every empire. That was
right.
The Bible says, hey, look. Yeah, the Bible says, look. We had them. They had us in captivity. They're going to be in captivity in the kingdom of heaven. But they're not getting out of it.
Now,
we're going to read it. We're
going to
read it.
Just, the reason democracy.
No, let's finish this right quick.
The reason democracy works.
Brother, hold on, brother. Democracy is demonocracy. Right, go ahead.
For the things which are seen are temporal, but the things which are not seen are eternal.
So the things that are not seen are eternal, man. And it's not going. We're not going to be in unison holding hands. That's not coming to pass. Right, go ahead.
This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 14 at the top. For the Lord will have mercy on Jacob.
Jacob is the forefather of the 12 tribes of Israel. Go ahead. And will yet choose Israel.
Who was God choose?
And will yet choose Israel. And set them in their own land.
Right, so the reason why we're not leaving this place right now, because God is going to set us back in our homeland.
That's right.
And the strangers shall be joined with them.
What is the white man?
And the strangers shall be joined with them.
The Chinese?
And the strangers shall be joined with them.
The Japanese?
And the strangers shall be joined with them.
What's the Arab?
And the strangers shall be joined with them.
What's the non-Israelite African?
And the strangers shall be joined with them. And they shall cleave to the house of Jacob.
They're going to cleave to the 12 tribes of Israel. Go ahead.
And the people shall take them captive. And the people shall take them and bring them to their place.
Right, so we're going to bring them to the place of our heart's desire, which God is God's place that he wants us to bring them to. Go ahead.
And the house of Israel.
What?
And the house of Israel. Shall possess them.
Shall do what?
Shall possess them.
Do you possess that camera and that stick that you hold right now? Is that your possession?
Correct.
So it doesn't belong to nobody else, right?
Correct.
So when he says the house of Israel shall possess them, what do you think that's for? He said they're going to bring...
The house of Israel will possess the strangers.
Right, okay. The strangers. Go ahead. Okay.
And the house of Israel shall possess them in the land of the Lord. For servants,
the white man gonna be
for servants. Man. For servants.
Okay, so check
for
it out.
Servants.
So what you're saying is the Bible gave you a green card to be a hypocrite. You know what you're saying? Because you hate being a slave, and but you're looking forward to the day you own.
We're gonna answer that.
And the land of the Lord for servants and handmaids.
What's the white woman gonna be?
For servants and handmaids.
You got your white girlfriend? Come on, Ebenezer, tell the truth, man.
Ebenezer!
You like the pink stink. You like the pink stink, Ebenezer.
Snow bunny.
And they shall take them captives, whose captives they were. And they shall rule.
We shall what?
And they shall rule.
What we gonna do?
And they shall rule.
What we gonna do?
And they shall rule. Over their oppressors,
the white man.
Over their oppressors,
the white woman.
Over their oppressors,
killing Emmett Till.
Over their oppressors, and it shall come to pass in the day that the Lord shall give thee rest.
He's gonna give us rest.
That's right.
We're gonna rule over our oppressors, man. You gotta understand that, Ebenezer.
Yes.
Hey, look, that's God's judgment. You know what I'm saying? You trying to understand why God endorses slavery? It's in the law. The God told the Israelites, all your slaves could be of non-Israelite people.
You reap what you sow, right?
You reap what you sow. Give me that Galatians chapter 6.
This is the book of Galatians.
6 and 7.
Chapter 6 and verse 7. Be not deceived.
Be not what?
Be not deceived. God is not mocked.
What does the Bible say?
God is not mocked. For whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap.
Right, so whatever a man soweth, and what did they sow? They sowed genocide. They sowed rape. They sowed murder. They sowed death in the earth, man. And God said, yeah, we just read it. And he said, whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap. Yeah, we told our ancestors. Yes, holy men.
I didn't necessarily accept all the way. Uh-huh. But remember, I was dissecting even he who wrote it.
Yeah, but you have to.
Because, and that's what I'm saying.
Go ahead.
You mean to tell me a book gave you a green card to be hypocritical?
No, we hypocrites.
If you hate something, why impose it upon the next man?
Does God hate?
Of course he does.
Okay. I'm not imposing it on no other man. I'm not imposing.
Celebrating. You guys just jubilated.
I celebrate God's word,
one
man.
One day owning your own slave.
I celebrate God's word because God said that's what's going to happen.
That's
what
we got. Chris on 28.
Okay.
So you saying that we want to be racist and we want to be, we're using the Bible.
You're using the Bible to be a hypocrite.
Okay, but look what God says about these people.
You got to look into who wrote the Bible.
Okay, but look, we did. We were in slavery, so we didn't.
You got to be careful when you wrote it.
We're just reading it.
Because it's human beings who wrote it.
Okay.
Every human being has a guys usually have an agenda.
Ebenezer, but we're
be
reading.
Careful with that.
But look, we're just reading.
Don't be a follower, which is the next man's agenda.
Deuteronomy 28 from the top. And it shall come to pass, if thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe to do all his commandments, which I command thee this day, that the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all nations of the earth.
What?
That I will set you on high above all nations of the earth.
God told the Israelites, if you keep my commandments, I'm going to put you above all people upon the face of the earth. That is racism right there, right?
Let's do this. Huh? You know about Sharia law, right? You know about the Muslim law, right?
Yeah, Muslim law, yeah.
You know how they operate. I just talked about the towers, blowing up things.
We don't operate like that, yeah.
We don't. You don't.
No, we don't.
You don't. You realize, not using common sense, 1 plus 1 equals 2, nice to my brother, regardless of who, and literally saying, the Bible tells me you're not one of the 12 people, so screw you. Is doing exactly
all that rhymes too.
All
that rhymes.
Give me Revelation 21 and 2.
Exactly what you just said. I don't condone.
Well, look, this is the key thing that you got to understand, right? God said we're going to pay them back double for what they did to us. But at the end all be all, after 1,000 years, we're going to let them go, and then we're going to heal the nations, but they're still going to be under us.
Guess what? So you believe in an eye for an eye? Yes?
God says eye for an eye.
No, don't worry about what God says. No,
well, hold on, everybody. Whoa, Nelly.
You know why? You know why? Because they are God's with an S.
Well, there's only one supreme God, though.
Alrighty then.
There's only one omniscient God.
But your Bible itself talked about gods.
It did. But
you stopped him when he did it.
You got to understand there was a supreme power that gave them the authority to do it.
There is something better.
No, there's nothing better than Yahweh.
Right.
There is nothing better than Yahweh, the existing one.
From the book, right?
So we're going to deal with that because y'all know you got the Anunnaki spirit. And in these last days, everybody believe in the Anunnaki's
superpowers
and all that. Well, the Anunnaki's is a damn lie, okay? That's not, that was something created in the ancient world. Hold on, give me a second. Those are ancient world gods, like the Sumerians and all that. They believe in that, right? But when you look at the Bible, all right, that word God, or gods with the S, is like the brother was saying, Allahayo, which the Muslims, they took that and ran with it, right? Because we was here first, man, as far as institutional-wise, right? So look, Allahayo means rulers, judges, angels. So when God was creating man, he commanded the angels, the rulers of that time, to create what, you know, God told, God in our image. So when God says, make man in our image, he was just commanding his angels and the Lord, the Son of God, to do so. So it wasn't no Anunnakis because they was all under Yahweh.
I tried to take a step back from all our intellect and go down to basic human
How you doing, family?
I try to take a step away from our books and from our given intelligence. Let's just go, if the shoe fits, let's wear it.
Yes.
We don't know who made the shoe. We don't know how good the thread is. But we do know this.
Yes.
If it fits you, please wear it and see how far it takes you.
Okay, well, so, let me hit you with this, because look, even scholars would all agree. Check this out.
I'm saying that to say this.
Yes.
We look at one culture do the craziest things because of a book.
Yeah.
And let's us not do the same.
But we're not acting upon the things that God says is going to happen. God is going to intervene himself through his son and his angels, and they're going to implement those things. You know what I'm saying? Because give me St. John chapter 18 and verse 36 right there. Hold on, real quick. I'm going to explain it though for you right now. Because look, we're going to rule them. We're going to rule them in righteousness. He's got St. John 18 and 36. We're not going to do the same exact things that they did to us. Like in regards to raping women. We're not going to operate like that. Yeah, they're going to be our servants and handmaids, as we read earlier. St. John 18 and 36. Yeah, bring this out right quick.
This is Revelations 21 and 2. And I, John.
Let me see.
actually tried 22 and one.
So you remember earlier when I said, so you believe in an eye for an eye, and you said that's what God said, and I said, let's not worry about what God said. You remember that part?
Yes.
You know what? The reason I said that was this. I think recently, if I'm not mistaken, I can't remember the country. I don't even want to guess. Let's say Mandela. Nelson Mandela, who was in prison for X amount of years.
Yes.
When he got out of jail, do you think as soon as he got out of jail, he went trying to imprison all those and became president? He went back trying to pay back all those who did him wrong?
No. But he was compromised, though.
What do you say was compromised?
Because the people who had power over him gave him that seat of authority as being the president. You know what I'm saying? But he knew that they had also had the power to throw him back inside.
Okay,
if he didn't submit to their their authority.
My point is this, though. They say two wrongs don't make a right. Do you agree?
Obama. You want to switch to Obama?
They're all the same premise. A person who was done wrong, choosing to do right.
But how was Obama done wrong?
When he was given his inauguration speech.
Yes.
In the House, when he was elected president. In the House, he was speaking.
That's white people's innate racism. Whatever you're about to say, they have an innate.
He was going through a lot himself right then. He was surrounded by a House that was against him, and he knew.
Well, his mother's lineage. He came from the same lineage as all the other presidents, man. They all have a connection somehow or some way.
The speech he gave brought all people together, at least for that night. That night when he gave the speech, everybody felt like a brother and sister. Why? Because the man decided to overlook the wrongs that were done to him.
But you know what he did? You know what he did?
Listen, coincide with that? Even Jesus Christ.
What did he do? You bringing Jesus into the same sentence as Obama? Hold him now, but look, Obama...
It's the same perspective. But it's kind of like someone doing me, pushing me down right now, and then my boys want to jump him, and I get up and I say, no.
See?
Let him be.
But no, Obama was compromised, because in doing what he did, in forgiving those people or not, you know, giving in to the temptation of getting back at people, he ignored all of the people on this side right here. What did he do?
I said, what do you do to help him?
Yeah, because you know, one of the years of Obama's presidency, it was one of those years was worse than any year of Jim Crow, as far as how black people were getting murdered by police.
If Obama was running against Trump, who would you go for? You would go for Trump.
Yeah, look, I don't vote at all. Right. Let me make that clear. I don't vote at all. But if you want to say hypothetically.
Who would you go for right now? Obama against Trump, who would you go for?
Vote for Trump, certainly.
I'm going to vote for Trump. That's crazy.
Hypothetically speaking.
You said hypothetically.
Yeah. But we don't vote at all.
We don't vote. But you gave us a hypothetical. Yeah, but still, you're leaning to what the president
You know why?
Expects.
Because you're democracy is like democracy. I said earlier, demonocracy.
Right.
All right? So they give an illusion like, oh, the Democrats aren't racist. Right. No, it's this left wing, right wing, it's the same goddamn bird.
Right.
They're racist on both sides, man. Right. They're racist with the Republicans and they're racist with the Democrats,
right,
man.
That's crazy. So you literally are saying you would go with the devil that you pointed out many times.
We say hypothetically. We're not voting for nobody.
This is why
we would say Trump over Obama. Obama instituted homosexuality. Corrupted majority of black communities.
Oh, so right.
Yes.
Sometimes the person who doesn't look like you aligns more with you. Is that what I'm hearing?
What you mean?
Sometimes a person who does not look like you, skin tone, might have better morals than a person who looks just